welcome to Ninian Park, Cardiff, for the first of today's two home internationals for the British International Championship. Wales beginning the day at the bottom of the table, having lost their one previous game, played against England at Wembley back in February. The only other match so far in the tournament ended in a 0-0 draw. It was at Hampden on Tuesday between Scotland and Northern Ireland. So Kevin Jackett moves into midfield, and the problem position up front in the absence of the injured Ian Rush is filled by the Swansea striker Jeremy Charles. Scotland makes seven changes compared with Tuesday night. The four Aberdonians return. Dalgleish is injured. Charlie Nicholas is rested. So Andy Gray's partner up front is Alan Brazil, who has another chance to end his scoring drought for Scotland, winning today his 12th cap. The pitch has had a lot of rain on it, and it looks like the biggest Scottish support here for many years. Scotland with the midweek match this time against England at Wembley. Many of them seem to have chosen the weekend to come down to Wales. I think the best distinguishing feature between the two sides, Wales are wearing the dark socks and are defending the goal to our left. It's Brazil. Scored 10 goals for Ipswich during the season and 6 for Tottenham. Cleese follows it. Charles wins it. Thomas. Charles gets away again, but doesn't find Flynn. It's an unlucky collision. Here's Frank Gray. Andy Gray is on the far side. Brazil. The Welsh making a few problems for themselves, and in the end it's a free kick to Wales. And McLeish with the header, and Gray, it came off him. So 12 minutes of the match gone, Andy Gray the scorer. Nicholas. Brazil catching Joey Jones while sleeping. Gray. Well, Jones woke up in time enough. It's Kevin Ratcliffe. Price. Flynn. Thomas. He did well. So he didn't get anywhere near really, because it was hit quite across. Quite a strong cross ball. Miller. He was a bit surprised at the verdict. Charles poised for the run left to right. And he's got to, in fact, move back. And here's Slatter. He's a little bit hurried, which I suppose is understandable. And Leighton, cleared away by Frank Gray. It was curling away from him, the cross. It was a real teasing one for the keeper. Davis, Jones, Radcliffe, great. Scottish ball. That was on Brazil. It's become the almost only Scottish chant now. Here we go, here we go. Free kick against Joey Jones. Frank Gray, Andy Gray at the back, and got the header down. It was well taken by Southall, who was very tight on his near post, and certainly sprang well. Frank Gray's cross, Andy Gray coming in for the header. He's right on that post, and he took it well, he needed to. Brazil down the middle. Thomas. Nicholas, nicely done, but not there. Gray. Gray. Shielded it well then from Paul Price. Here's Charles for Wales. Davis has come over to the right. And the flag stays down. And Jim Leighton gave Gordon Davis nothing to shoot at all. Good play by Jeremy Charles. The linesman on the far side kept his flag down. I think he was right. Looked as though it was Souness who played him on. And maybe Goff as well. Strachan. Some good individual moments here. Well struck. Seem to be pretty big hands that Neville Southall got round the ball. Goff. He's like to get forward this fullback. Andy Gray. Bannon. Frank Gray. Here's Goff, side netting, stole up on the far side, completely unnoticed, nobody went with him, but his header made the side netting. Goalkeeper in fact had covered the angle anyway, I think, and Bannon who picked out the unmarked man. Encouraged to put it out by Leighton. Referee has one check of the watch. And the Welsh skipper ends in possession, but it's Scotland who lead at half time. The goal scored in the 12th minute, the header by Alex McLeish, which Andy Gray turned in on the goalkeeper's left hand post. So the end of a very lively 45 minutes. Wales 0, Scotland 1. Scotland now attacking the goal to our right. Oh, Frank Gray. Nicholas, just enjoying the role of captaincy. Gordon Davis, Kenny Jacket. And McLeish and Charles getting to know each other again immediately. The Welsh manager, Mike England, down on the bench. He was in the last Welsh side to lose to Scotland in Wales 10 years ago. Now looking for a hat-trick of successes on Welsh soil. Jones. Davis. Nicholas. Strachan. This could be promising. Bannon on the left side. Joey Jones and Chase, the ball will beat them both. No, it won't. Bannon keeps it in. And gets the cross. But under United man, who only came into the squad because Jim Bett has gone back to play football in Belgium for Lokeren. Certainly fooled everybody then. Cross, well taken. Price. It's not the most cultured moments of football we've seen. Ends with a free kick to Scotland. And Brian Flynn is being replaced by the Newport striker Steve Lowndes. So this is a tactical move by Wales to put an extra forward on. Number 13 comes on with 13 and a half minutes of the second half gone. Slatter. Strachan. Oh, he's made the gap. If he's got the pace to go, goalkeeper off his line. Good save. Bannon. And still. But wide. Well, Gordon Strachan. What a good little run. Pushed it through the gap, and the Welsh had to let him go. At least once he was in the area, the goalkeeper narrowed the angle well and blocked well. And in the end, the ball came square to Eamon Bannon. Picked it up, and the right foot shot curled the wrong way for him. Gordon Strachan, who will hope to find that sort of form at Wembley on Wednesday, and he'll be making his first appearance there. So 1-0 to Scotland. Foul by Price. Joey Jones gets the foot in. Joey Jones, incidentally, just voted player of the year at Chelsea. Still on the line. Goff is up. So is McLeish here. Strachan. Souness. Oh, that's lovely. And it very nearly worked. Brazil, it might still. Yes, he ends the drought. Alan Brazil at long last, after Souness had played the initial ball through. And I must say that Alan Brazil has a face of almost embarrassment, because in the end the luck came to him, the luck which has deserted him before, but it was a lovely ball through that was looking for Goff. Southall couldn't control it, Brazil did, and I must say very well, and in the end scored with his right foot. 23 minutes of the second half gone, and Scotland now with a comfortable lead, which is being well celebrated. Massive flags on the far side. It's a miniature Hampden here. Lance. It's been given no change at all by Frankie Gray. Charles. Miller across. He was pushed. Souness. Control in both areas. Graham Souness will respond to the cries of the crowd, which are entirely accurate. They're going to Wembley there on Wednesday evening. And there's Jacket. Oh dear, oh dear. He was made such a meal of the side foot. It's a heaven-sent opportunity. Fish well fooled. And he tried to place it with the side of his foot and it curled off it instead. Thomas. Souness. Goff. Strachan. Obviously affected by his miss. Casual pass from Jeremy Charles. Charles, who had a good start to the match, but has been kept under control by McLeish for an awful long time. Davies. Nicholas. Oh! And Mickey Thomas on the six-yard line. That's quite incredible. There have been two clear scoring opportunities for Wales since they went two down, and both have produced quite awful misses. Gordon Davies with the turn. And Thomas, as he got the ball from Nicholas, well, I don't think he even made contact of any sort. Jacket. Still on for Charles? No, it's not. It's a corner. Lowndes has come across to take it. Joey Jones again on the near post. His usual beat. Gordon Davies behind him. Ratcliffe. Charles. Price, Thomas, oh, it's a good try! Oh, he was very unlucky then. missed a few moments ago. Nearly scored the most spectacular goal of the afternoon. Ball bouncing around. It's been pretty lively. Header out from Willie Miller. And it was a great turn. And he was unlucky not to keep it down sufficiently at the end. Brazil. He's gone back inside to go on his left. Goff. Souness. Bannon. Two waiting. Andy Gray. Yes, he's entitled to look like that. By no means an extreme reaction. He was certainly close, and some more good work by Bannon. Gray, that close, and the gap was not covered by Neville Southall. Brazil. David Neri. Brazil. Neri. Oh, he struck that one with more of the power of which he's capable. Brazil who set up the opportunity. And Southall really made a fine save. Nobody in the six-yard box for the Scots. Goff, Gray, nicked away from him by Nicholas. Davis. Snapshot from him without much backlift. Davis, who would like, as Brazil has done, to finally got a first goal for Wales. Well, this is only his seventh cap this afternoon. Ratcliffe. Seconds running out for Wales to have at least a consolation goal. Charles. Welsh ball. Bryce and Davis taking a rather despairing leap at it. Just couldn't get there. Couldn't get sufficiently there to direct a header. Price who turned it across the box. Davis took a flying leap at it. And Scotland have their first victory on Welsh soil for 10 years. Their first at Ninian Park since 1962. And the two goal scorers congratulate each other. The two strikers, Andy Gray in the 12th minute, Alan Brazil in the 68th, finally getting on the score sheet for his country, and with the Scots flags waving, a performance to please their manager, Jock Steed.